Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to generate random numbers and strings. So there are many ways to generate random numbers and string in Java. So I will show you a few important approaches. Now go to your Eclipse and in my project, I'll just create a new class and I will name it as generate random numbers and strings. Right, so now take this main method and then finish. So here, first of all, let's see how we can generate random numbers. So to generate random numbers, we have multiple approaches. The first approach one is we can use a random class. So we have a built-in class in Java, and by using this class, we can create a random numbers. So for that, what you have to do is first we need to create an object for random class. So let's say random, rand equal to new random. Now let's import this random from java.util package from Java. Now by using this object rand, we need to call a method called next int. So that will generate integers, random integers. So for example, let's say rand dot, I'll say next rand. So you can also generate a decimal numbers, random decimal numbers. So let's say rand dot, the method name is next int. So next int, so this will generate a random number. But here we need to provide a number of digits. So for example, so when I say, for example, 10, so it will consider from 0 to 9. So from 0 to 9, it will pick up one of the number. And similarly, when I say 100, it will pick up 0 to 99, it will pick up one of the number and it will generate the random number. So maximum limit is 999. So this is a maximum limit. So that means when I say 1000, it will generate random number between 0 to 999, right? So for example, let us say 10 for now. So I'm just storing this random number in a variable. Let's say it will return an integer value. So I'll say integer random int. Okay, this is a variable, so which can hold a random integer. Now let's print this value. I'll just print system.out.println and just printing this value. So now I have given 10 here. So this number should be between 0 to 9. Now let's execute. Run as Java application. So now it is written 5. So now next time when I run this again, so this time 3, again run it, this time 1. So it will generate random number between 0 to 9. So let's make as 100 now. I'll make it as 100. Now it will generate random number between 0 to 99. Now when I run a Java application, now it is giving 85. And again, one more time, it is giving 62. And one more time, it is giving 45. So let's make it as 1000 now. And run as, so it is giving 563, random number, three digits number, and then 15, and then 214, and then again, so 104. So it is generated random number. So when I say 1000, it will generate from 0 to 999. There's a maximum limit. So this is how we can generate random integers. Suppose we can also use this random object to generate decimal numbers. So for that, what you have to do is we have to call one more method called rand dot next double. This is a method, next double. So here we don't need to pass any parameter. So by default, it will generate decimal numbers between range 0.0 and less than 1.1. So this is a basic range. So from 0.0 to less than 1.0. So between these two ranges, it will generate random decimal numbers. Now let me generate some of the numbers. So here I'll just store that return number in a variable. Let's say double random, I'll say DBL. This is a variable name. Now I'm printing this value inside this variable. I'll write system.out.println and I'll print that value. So this will give you a number will print in a console window, which will be, comes between 0.0 to less than 1.0. Let me comment these two things. Right, so now let's run this now. All right, so now 0 point some decimal number is given. And when I run one more time, so it is giving different number. Again, one more time and it is giving different number. So all these numbers fall between 0.0 to less than 1.0. So by using random class, there is a methods next int and next double. By using these methods, we can generate random numbers. So this is a one approach. By using random class, we can create a random numbers, both integers and doubles. And there is one more approach. Let me just comment all these things. And to generate the number, there is one more approach by using math class. Let's say approach two. So in approach two, we can use math class. So, but in the math class, we have again a methods. So we have a random method again. So by using that method, we can generate only decimal numbers, right? So after that, if you want to extract integers from the decimals, we can extract integers. But by default, we can generate decimal numbers. Let's see how we can do this. So we can simply say math class. Math is a class dot. There is a method called random. So this random is a static method which is there inside the math class. So we can directly call this random method by using class name itself. So here we no need to create any object for the math class. So let's print this statement and see what this is printed. System.out.println math.random. All right. So just print it. Run as Java application. So now it is giving some value, and again run it one more time, and again it is giving different decimal number. Again it is giving decimal number. So every time it will generate a new decimal number randomly. Okay, so this is also works fine. So this is another approach to generate random decimal numbers. So apart from this, we also have a third approach. In this, we can use a third-party API, that is Apache Commons Lang API. So we can also use Apache Commons Language API. So basically, this API is provided to generate random numbers as well as strings. Both we can generate. Now, let's see how we can use this particular API to generate random numbers and random strings, so which is very, very useful API. Most of the times, we use this in Java projects. Now we'll see how we can use this API to generate random numbers as well as random strings. Right, I am commenting the approach two. Now I'm going to show you approach three, how we can generate random numbers and strings by using Apache Commons Language API. So first of all, we need to see what exactly this API is, and we need to download a driver for them. So let me just Google it. So once you Google it, it will give you this one. So commons.apache.org. So Apache Commons Lang 3.4 is the latest version. So now click on this. I think not this one. Let me just go to the official website. I think this is the official website. Let me just go through this. Not this. Let me just get the URL. All right. So now I capture. So this is a URL. I can just directly open this URL in the Google. Now it will give you, yeah, this is Apache Commons API. So we need to just download one jar file. So here, if you just go to download section, somewhere it should be there. Let me just refresh. So we need to download this particular API jar file. All right, so in this link, you can find a download link here under language. So click on the download. Now it will go to download page. This is currently we are in the download page. So here we need to download a zip file. So if you are currently working on Windows operating system, you have to download this, or any other operating system, Linux or Unix, you can have to download tar file. Now click on the binary zip file. So once you click on this, it will download one zip file and go to the folder and extract the zip file. And once you extracted this zip file, you will get a folder. Inside this, you will see multiple jar files. So we need to have this particular jar file, so which contains a number of classes and by which we can create a random numbers and strings. So once you extracted this, what you have to do is just go to Eclipse. Now, whatever project currently you are working, and right click on the project, go to properties. Now inside the Java build path and go to the libraries tab here. And currently we have a JRE is only the library which is attached to our project. Now go to external jars, add external jars. Now select the jar file. So common slang 3 t.9.jar. This is only one jar we need to add, attach, and then apply and close. So now this jar file comes under referenced libraries. Okay. So now we can use certain number of functions here. Alright. So once we have added jar files, we have a method called random string utils, which is a class which is coming from the jar file. Coming with the jar file. Now we need to use that particular class, random string utils. Now let's see how we can use this class. Let's say random string utils, and this is a class which is coming from this jar file, common language package, and dot, there is a method called random numeric. Let me write it down. Dot random numeric. So this is a method. So random string utils dot random numeric, and here we do give how many number of digits you should have in random number, so that you can specify here. So for example, when I say 5 here,
it will generate a number which contains a 5 digits, which contains a 5 digits. Now let's see, store that number in a variable.
Here I'll create one string variable. So even though it is a number, it will return in the form of string. So we have to create one variable called random number variable. Now we can just print this value. So here I'll say system.out.println. I can just print a random number. Right, so this will print a random number which contains 5 digits. So if you want to generate a random number with a 10 digits, we can just increase the value, right? Now let's try this. Run as Java application. So now it is generated a number which contains 5 digits. So now again, if you run this, it will give you one more number, which is also having 5 digits. Now another number which is also having 5 digits. Suppose I want to generate a number with 10 digits, right? So now we can just run as, and now it is having 10 digits. Now again, run it, it will generate 10 more digits. So this is the way we need to generate a random numbers by using random string utils. So even though we are this is returning as a string format, we can convert this into number format later. Okay, so similarly we can also generate a string. So random string also we can generate. So we have again same class, random string utils. Inside the class we have one more method called random alphabetic. Random alphabetic. So here also we need to specify a number, like it will dynamically take from A to Z characters, and how many characters should be there in your string. So that we need to specify. So let us say I have 5 here. So in my string I should have 5 characters which are randomly taken from A to Z. Now I'll store that in another string variable. Let's say random str. After that let's try to print it. I'm printing this random str, right? So now I'm printing one string randomly and which contains 5 characters. Let's comment this one and then run it. All right, so now it is generated 5 characters a string. Now I'll make it as a 10 now, then it will generate a string which contains a 10 characters, right? So we can just change the number of characters you should have in my string, so accordingly you can generate a random string. So this is how Apache Commons Language API provided these two methods, random numeric and random alphabetic. And by using them, we can generate our random numbers and also random strings. So this is how we can generate random numbers and random strings in Java. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.